Christine is a 1983 horror film directed by esteemed horror director John Carpenter and is based upon the novel written by the esteemed horror author Stephen King. And just that alone should get you excited. Stephen King and John Carpenter collaboration. Something truly amazing is in the works because we are talking about one of my favorite John Carpenter films, Christine, and perhaps one of Stephen King's most interesting stories, which on the surface doesn't seem like it should be, but it really is. So the first time I saw Christine was several years ago, at least, it must be at least 5 years ago, on AMC's Fear Fest, where it was edited for TV. There's different versions of Christine out there with different levels of gore and violence. But I watched one for the first time, and I wasn't like the biggest fan of it, and I've seen it a few times since. And on my most recent viewings, I've really grown an appreciation for Christine, and I consider it now to be one of John Carpenter's best, and even in my ranking of my top horror films, because Christine, I don't know how to describe it, but it's a fun movie on the surface, and if you look a little deeper, it's even more fascinating. But on the surface, Christine is a movie about a boy who, you know, is kind of a nerd. His name's Arnie, not very popular in school. He has a couple friends, a lot of bullies, of course, and decides to get this really cool car. I think it's a 1967 Plymouth Fury, red. And he, you know, soups it up, makes it all really, really nice in this auto shop, and it kind of has a mind of its own. And when Christine, the name of the car, gets bashed in brutally by the bullies from Arnie's school, it begins to take on a life of its own and begins to murder the bullies and the people around Arnie in his life. Now, there's a whole kind of debate in the movie whether Arnie's actually behind the wheel or Christine's driving herself. We don't really know. And John Carpenter alludes to different, you know, there's different scenes that kind of suggest different things. But what I love about the movie is the way it's shot and how it's composed together to create this story that's, you know, a really character-driven story. Arnie is consumed by his love for his hobby car. And because of that, it infiltrates his family life, his friend life, even his relationship life with his girlfriend. And that's a story that I think a lot of people can relate to. When your hobby, when what you love kind of takes over your entire life for the worse, I really respect that story. It's a story that a lot of people wouldn't think of telling, but Stephen King does it in this really great way. Now, you can look at that deep, you know, kind of deeper meaning of Christine, or you can look at it from the surface, being a killer car movie, and it still succeeds. The music choices are excellent throughout the whole movie. It's got a real 50s feel to it. I guess maybe 60s feel, because it's a 1967 Plymouth Fury. Or is it 57? I don't know. It's an old car. It's an old junker at the beginning, and he makes it really, really nice. But there's a lot of really nice songs played throughout the movie. Kind of like, if I had to relate it to anything that you might be contemporarily familiar with, Bumblebee from the Transformers movies, you know, when he talks and it's like through the radio? Christine kind of talks like that too, to the audience, to Arnie, to the different characters, through the radio and the songs. Now, the actual score of the movie, which was done by John Carpenter as traditional, is excellent. I think it's a really great score. Very simple, kind of like all of his scores, but it even adds car noises into the music to let you know what kind of movie you're watching. And from the very opening, you understand that Christine is a dark force. You don't even know where this darkness comes from. There's different suggestions. There was a man who killed himself in the car. But really, from its very inception, from the creation of this vehicle, it has always been evil. And even at the end of the movie, it alludes to the fact that the evil will never end. What's really weird to me is that there were no sequels, at least that I'm aware of, to Christine. And you think there would be, or even a remake with a self-driving car. I feel like that's pretty obvious. But for the horror genre, which loves to crank out sequel after sequel, you would think a movie about a killer car would be pretty easy to do. There are other killer car movies out there like The Car and Maximum Overdrive, but for me, Christine is more about its characters and really understanding the dynamic between Arnie, his girlfriend, and his best friend, along with his parents and the bullies. It sets up that world really well, and Christine is the thing that drives them all apart. Get it? Drives? You see what I did? Whatever. The point is, Christine is a really great horror film, not just fun on the surface. It's got a deeper meaning. And for a movie that's ultimately about a killer car that could just be full of gore and people getting hit, which it has that too, but it gives enough time to the plot and to the characters where you appreciate it as a film as well as being a pretty thrilling horror movie too. So check out Christine if you haven't. Definitely a fan favorite of yours truly. And I'm going to give it a 4.5 out of 5 skulls on the RIP Reviews rating scale.
Let me tell you a little something about love, Dennis. It has a voracious appetite. It eats everything. Friendship. Family. It kills me how much it eats. But I'll tell you something else. You feed it right, and it can be a beautiful thing, and that's what we have.
Thank you for watching, and remember as always, for all things Halloween, this is Hauntformer. People knocking, but they can't come in. People knocking.